वेलकम टू द ऑप्टिमम कैड सॉल्यूशन, द वे टू ऑप्टिमाइज। आई एम पंकज रत्नपारखी। वंस अगेन विल स्टार्ट अवर फ्री ऑनलाइन कोर्स दैट इज प्लास्टिक प्रोडक्ट डिजाइन एंड एडवांस कटिया। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिजाइन एन इंटरेस्टिंग पार्ट ऑफ ए ऑटोमोबाइल दैट इज डिजाइन ऑफ ए मैनिफोल्ड। सो दोज आर द ऑनलाइन कोर्स कंटेंट एंड वी आर एट एडवांस कटिया। सो पॉइंट्स विच ऑलरेडी कवर्ड ड्यूरिंग द कोर्स एंड वीडियोज आर अवेलेबल ऑन यूट्यूब चैनल। सो विदाउट वेस्टिंग द टाइम लेट्स विल स्टार्ट द डिजाइन of a manifold. The manifold is an engine device which is used in automobile to drive the air just like the duct. So let's open the gutia and we'll start the design of a manifold. So we are in the gutia. So take a origin point, axis system, hide the default plane. So now we started with the sketch. So we are in the sketch, so we will start with this rectangle. The section is a square, so we'll take a center rectangle. We'll give the dimension, the square it is 125 mm. So this is the base sketch. So we'll use the advanced surfacing, extrude command with 350 mm extend. So this is the base rectangular shape. So we'll apply the edge fillet of a 25 mm. So you can see the exact design. This is the rectangular shape we designed. Now we'll move towards this cylindrical part. So let's start with the sketch. So the circles are away from 200 mm from center plane. So we'll take a center plane here, 200 mm away, and we'll draw the respective circles. So today we don't have any reference of a 2D drawing. So we are going to imagine all the dimensions and we are designing the imaginary manifold design. So for your reference, you can refer these dimensions as it is. So this is the 200 mm from the center, so we'll take a 220, and thus there are the two circular hole or a circular pattern at the right side and left side. So we'll mirror as per the dimensions, so you can refer the dimensions from this video. So we'll use the output profile. We require that two center points of the circle for sweep command. So kindly note that we require the two points and one center point for doing the soft sweep command. So just refer whatever we are going to do. Let's take a common cylindrical center point. So now, as we know that for sweep command the guide curve is required, so we'll draw the this type of a guide curves here. So let's take a line from the point and direction, and we'll give the 50 mm in opposite direction. So here is the line. Let's take a similar one, the same line from that common point. We'll give the dimension here, 100 mm. Let's we'll preview. Firstly, we need to decrease by 10 mm, 90 mm. So here is the 90. Okay, let's we'll use the spline command here. So select the point, give the direction, select the point, give the direction. So this is the spline. So here we got our guide curve. Let's join those two profiles here. Now same guide curve for right side circle also. So let's draw, use the common line, Similarly, we can use the spline command here. And here the second guide curve is designed. So first of all, we'll design LH side circular parts, and after then we'll mirror it through the center plane. So here is the sketch is get completed. So let's use the sweep command, select the profile, select the guide curve. Here we got a solution. So this is the similar shape we got as per our today's task. So we'll hide unnecessary parts that will easily visualize what is we are going to do. So here the basic RH sides and circular joinery get completed. So this is the joinery part, as I already we see already in the design task. So let's use the trim command, select both of the circular parts, and the inner part get trimmed. You can see now again we are using the trim command with the rectangular part and joinery portion. So let's we'll do again, and we'll mirror this. Okay, before that we'll mirror this, and after then we'll use the different trim command for LH and RH. So those are the four joinery parts, circles with a joinery. So you can see in the task. So we'll trim the joinery parts with the basic rectangle. So here you can remove the internal part. Same trim for RH side. And finally we got this solution. So we'll apply the chamfer, apply the radius at the sharp edge, joinery sharp edge. Okay, it's 10 mm, it's enough I think. Okay. So let's remove the internal sharp edge also. So with the similarly 10 mm. So here the basic, you can see our target part. So basic surfaces we just created now. So now let's moving towards the pocket, which you can see here. So internal part get removed. So those pockets, let's design. So those pockets are just above the joinery, you can see here. So those pockets just above the joinery. So similarly we'll design one pocket, one surface, and it is exactly mirror with the center plane. So kindly refer the dimensions. We'll take the joining portion as a reference here. And we'll draw from RH side here. So once again we'll draw. So those are the dimensions you can follow. Otherwise you can refer, you can take in imaginary dimensions also, because today we don't have any kind of a reference. So we'll give 35 mm here. So let's once again we'll check the dimensions. Okay, now let's take a extrude command here. So same way we will do the operations by using the trim command, split command. We'll do the pocket impression on our rectangular basic part. So we are using the split command here, individual split. Okay, so you can refer, we'll hide this one. So this is the split of our extruded part. So now once again we'll use the trim with that particular split. So here we got that portion. So now we'll join. Before that we'll mirror our splitted part. Okay, here we will mirror this split part through the center plane, and same we will do with RH side also. So now we have the three different surfaces, first two, three, and let's join all the hair. So now the operation remaining, that is to give the corners radiuses here. So we'll make some softness here instead of the sharp edges. So let's use the radius edge fillet command here. So 25 mm. So we'll take a sharp edges. So this is the 10 mm. Okay, this is the enough 15 mm. Okay, so here now the basic shape is get completed. Now just remaining flanges are get remains. So let's will start the design of a flanges. Before that we'll go in the part design, that is the solid. So so that we are using the close volume, so we need to close all the surfaces. By using the all the surfaces we'll close our complete surfacing profile, and after then we'll use the close volume in the part design. So here we closes all the portions. Let's make a combined join and we'll enter into the, we'll give the name here manifold as a manifold, and we'll enter into the part design. Now we'll insert a different body which having the name again manifold, but solid manifold, solid. Okay, it's so easy. The first one having the surfaces, and now we are in the part design to make some solid designing over there, remaining portion like a flanges. So first of all we'll use the close volume. So there is one sharp edge, so let's will remove that sharp edge by adding the radius over there. So 5 mm, 5 mm is a somewhat smaller. Let's read it and 10 mm. Okay, so as we know that, so we are going to design this flanges here, but before that we'll make a thickness here. So before that we'll use the shell command for the manifold solid. So we can use the thickness command also in this, but or also we can use the shell command. So instead of making solid close volume, we can use the thickness also. So we are applying the 2.5 mm thickness. Now let's take a offset plane 350 mm. Let's draw the remaining flanges. So let's take a reference of a basic rectangle internal. So we'll take a dimensions 180 by 180 square. So you can see the four holes, for those are the mounting holes. Let's will draw that. Let's take a dimensions 20 mm from the each corner, and the diameter is of a 15 mm. So this is the 20 mm. we'll edit, we'll use as a diameter 16 that the M14 can be inserted. So those are the four quantity of a holes, mounting holes are there. So we'll do that. So let's pad the flange by 15 mm. So as we know that the same flange, it is at the RS side also, so we can use the mirror command. But as we have the single body, so that maybe chance of a replication of the solid, so we can use the Boolean operation here. So just separate out the body, separate out the pad. Now let's do all the operations that are necessary. So let's mirror out from the center plane. So here we got a end to end flanges here. So let's giving some finishing operations like a chamfer and radiuses over there. So this is the 35 mm. So now you can see the shape, which is just exactly as per our. So this is the circular flange is remaining. So let's will draw again. We'll take a new body and let's design the circular flanges by the reference of the holes. So where are those holes? So here the sketch. Okay, so we taken the basic reference of a joinery holes or a joinery circles to draw the flange. So let's design the flange here, which just coincide with the reference holes. So this is the 55 mm, and let's pad for the 5 mm thickness. Okay, so here the joinery flanges are get completed. Let's mirror it and we'll do the, so this the total operations get completed. Now we'll add all the parts into the part body. So let's do the Boolean operations to adding the final manifold into the part body. So let's we'll apply the chamfer and if there is any requirement of a radiuses. So here the radius is required. And at this corner also. Okay, so this joinery part, so we'll use the 5 mm radius here and the entry chamfers. So select all the chamfer corners or chamfer edges. We'll use the 3 mm chamfer, and finally we finish the design of a manifold here. Today's video is get completed. Thank you for watching our YouTube channel. We'll try to share more and more technical knowledge related to the plastic product design and advanced cut here. But before that, you have to subscribe, like and share our videos, and do not forget to hit the bell icon. Thank you guys.